On that front, because Hillsborough school leaders have just voted unanimously against arming teachers in classrooms. Corey Davis continues our team coverage now. He's joining us live from the school board headquarters in downtown Tampa. And you know, if Hillsborough doesn't like it, you have to wonder how far this is going to go, Corey.
Hey, Keith, good evening to you. It might go far. Hillsborough, the eighth largest in the country, so others may follow in their path. But the board members are telling me they don't even want staff members with prior training to be able to use guns on campuses.
It's ludicrous. I mean, I just thinking about logistically, I want teachers to be able to focus on teaching the students.
We tracked down 5 of the 7 Hillsborough County School Board members for their thoughts on guns in schools.
Teachers are not used to having a militant stance on issues.
All of them are pushing for more funding, but not for training that could lead to arming teachers and support staff.
I think that they should provide the funding and the resources for us to even prevent people from coming into our schools.
I think that what is the answer is getting more mental health counselors available to be able to help the troubled students.
Right now, the way the bill is written, each county will be able to decide whether they want guns carried on campuses. For Hillsborough, there are already more no's than yeses.
Even if it does pass, I'm hoping that the governor sticks to what he said over the last few weeks and that he is not in favor of arming teachers or any additional staff on our sites.
And to go along with Hillsborough, the superintendent in Polk County has now come out speaking out against guns on school campuses. Keith?
Corey Davis, live in downtown Tampa. Thank you for that. And aid is on your side as we face the crisis in our classrooms. You can stay informed on the steps your child's school district is taking, as well as what our state lawmakers are doing to keep everyone safe on campus. Just go to WFLA.com and the free News Channel 8 app.